Hi guys, I've got everything more or less that you'll need here now, but it will be written underneath above the comments. Basically all you're going to need is some sort of translucent. I'm using Cernit and some black clay. I'm using Pardo black just because I want to try it out. I've also got I've got black pearl, but I don't want it that strong, the mica, so I've got a Fimo black pearl, which you don't need. You don't have to do this. You can just use normal black if you haven't got it, but I just want to try something. I just want to see how it looks. Alternating cutters. So I've got a 3 alternating and I've got a 2 alternating. So I'll do both. And then colour wise, if you're looking to do the colour I'm doing, you need some sort of a turquoisey, greeny blue colour. The only one I've got is Stream, which I tend to pick up rather often. But it's perfect colour for this, so who cares? And I've got some copper gold leaf, some copper leaf. So I'm just going to tidy up and then I'll be back ready to start. Okay, so here's my black. With my translucent, I cut the same amount as that, plus about another third. Okay, so it's about that much, so that would be 4 instead of 3, just because I want a little bit more green than black. Now I'm going to be a really good girl and put a finger cut on, and I've rolled this out on a number 2. It may need more than one, or one may be enough, but basically it's a case of too much is on there. I've noticed lately my camera doesn't pick up the richness of the colours, which is a pity, because this is the most beautiful shade and I've tried everything I can and I can't see how to alter anything. Okay, I'm going to let that dry, and while that's drying I'm just going to chop up the black. Put the right tissue blade. Okay, so I'm going to haphazardly cut it up. And then because it probably won't dry in time, when this is dry, this is the colour I used last time. This is how it came out, so I'm looking for it to be about that shade, so that gives you an idea. So you want to keep translucency but have colour. So when that's dry, I'm going to fold it over, and if it's the right shade, which I'm hoping it will be, I'm literally going to chop it up like this, so they'll be next to each other. I'm going to give this quite a good chop. I want the black to be there to compare against the green, but I don't want it taking over, which is why I've done a bit less, and I also don't want very big pieces. So I'm just chopping them up ready. Same with this as well. I personally prefer to have more pieces than less, because it ends up just looking like big long smears, and I don't want that. I want it to look like a stone. And I don't know if a stone exists in these colours. It's not turquoise as in the normal turquoise. The one I'm doing here is going to be very translucent, whereas with turquoise it's solid, so it may end up being some sort of fantasy stone. All that I care about is that it's pretty. Okay, so that's not dry yet, so I'm going to leave it a couple more minutes. If I add more, I'll let you know, and I'll cut it up ready for when I come back it's done. Okay, thanks. Okay, what I forgot to say is you're going to need mica powder. So what I've done is chosen the two closest mica powders I could. For this black, I've just used a noir. Now, I've already done that one just to save on time, because you don't need to watch me do it. But because this is Cernit, I thought I'd do this online, because I find this is the quickest way of getting Cernit done, because I've just sat here for ages now mushing these up and they just keep re-sticking to each other, don't they? So I don't know if I'm happy with this colour I'm putting in, but it's the closest I've got. So I'll start mixing them up. And as you mix, every bit of clay that gets covered, it won't stick anymore. So this is why even though at the moment it's like this, you just keep chopping, and each time you chop and add more mica, there's a little bit less sticky clay and a bit more mica covered clay. So that's why I'll do it this way. I just find it's working out best for me, and I just thought it might be a good tip for anyone else who gets frustrated with soft clays. Give it a quick little spin so more of it gets stuck to the mica powder. And the same again. I think it's be getting easier and easier now because there's less and less of it sticky. A bit and chop again. I just find overall this works out quicker than trying to do it the other way. I get so frustrated when it just keeps re-sticking and re-sticking. I mean, you can put it in the fridge. I didn't, so there you are. Now it's starting to really break apart nicely. And there's enough mica powder on this table, but if not, I'll add a bit more. Remember not to mumble. Just for anyone that has commented under a few of my videos, I am trying my best to turn the CC on two of them. I've got it on and I don't even know how I did it. I go through, it tells me it's on and then it's not, so I'm still struggling to get the subtitles and languages showing, but I do keep trying. I've googled it, I've followed so many, I don't know, I just can't work it out. But I just wanted you to be aware I'm not ignoring that, because I do appreciate people watch from many different countries when they watch tutorials. Okay, that is more than chopped up enough now. I've got a few big, a good bit of little, and some in between. So now I'm going to mix these together and then my hands are just absolutely in such a mess. I started off by getting alcohol ink on them because I wasn't patient enough to let it dry properly, and so yeah, this is all going through a very messy phase at the moment. But I love it. It's sort of, it's like letting your inner child out to play. Takes your mind away from everything going on in the world. Right, okay, that's probably enough. Now I'm going to add some copper leaf. I think copper looks nicer than gold, the richness on this one. I'm going to mix that in for now. I don't know if I should have done that before or after the liquid clay, but still, it'll be what a little bit. I'll add that much for now. I'll add the liquid clay and then I can add a bit more foil after. It's got nothing to stick to, so. Right. Liquid clay. If it was going any slower, it would be going backwards. I get so frustrated with this. A little bit more foil, which is gonna stick everywhere now. I don't want too much, but I want enough that it's going to show a little bit in all pieces, because I should get a few pieces out of this. Add a little bit more. I don't want there to not be enough. Right, I'm going to add a bit more liquid clay. Sorry, you can't see, but I've got to do it from above, haven't I? So. Right, I'm just going to clean my hands and use a bit of paper to roll this. It's a bit late for that, isn't it? It's like shutting the gate after the horse has bolted. But hey. Hope that's enough. Be lazy now, I'm using what's beside me. Go, that's about it. Let's clean this up a bit. I'll clean it properly in a minute off camera, but I need it a certain amount clean to continue. Okay. Right, I'm just going to roll this. I'm going to form it into a sausage. Manually. Okay, like that. Push the sides in. And then I'm just going to roll it. So I'm shaping it. I just find, I say less messy. It's a bit late in the day, like I say, but I thought I'd show you. And I enjoy doing it this way rather than chasing it around the table. There you go. Just like that, it's rolled. It went well this time. Last time I tried it, it was sticking and not working. Okay. So I'm going to leave that to dry and cool down, warm up. I don't want it warming up, do I? It'll be walking off. Yeah, I'll be back when this has had a chance to cool down, about 20 minutes. Hi, you're going to have to, sorry, you're going to have to excuse my nails and hands now, and across the messy line. So I'm going to slice it now, and I've just rolled out on number two just some translucent, add a bit of blue tinge to it, which is perfect. So that was my option for backing. I mean, you can do whatever colour you want. It's not going to be translucent where you've got to worry about the back being light. It's not going to be that sort of translucency. So whatever suits, I suppose. So I'm cutting them, trying to keep it sort of under 2mm, as flat as I can keep it. I'm going to run this through the pasta machine in a minute. I'm not sure whether to just down to a 0 or down to a 2. Ideally, I'd like to get it down to a 2, because these earrings, it's going to be like a triple earring. I mean, they're not hanging as one, so it's not that important, but I want to keep them as thin as I can so it's still pleasing to the eye. I'm not looking like concrete blocks hanging. So my ruler so it doesn't stick to it. Ease it down a bit and check there's no gaps, which is one of the important things. I'm just going to cut away the excess. Reasonably tidy. Right. Gonna push those a few little shallower looking bits. So, right, I'm just gonna put it through on number zero, see how it looks. And I'm going to give it a bit of a burnish. I think because of the kind of earrings they are. No, I don't know. I think I'm still going to take it down to a number two. I just add this off once. To a number two. Okay, now at this point, now it's on a number two, I'm actually going to add it to my baking tray so that I can cut while it's on the tray, just to make sure everything stays flat and nice. Gonna get, there is a few crackles in there, but they're not the fillable sort, it's ink. Yeah, but I'm sure that'll be fine because I think the old crackle will look nice. Okay, so I want the middle one of these cutters, which I just have, and now I've put somewhere away from the other two. Oh dear me. Come on, come out, wherever you are. I'm just going to go and find it and I'll be back. Okay, back where we were. So, where am I going to go? There's a nice kind of a blue shimmer coming from what would have been the mica powder at the moment. I hope that looks nice when it's done. So, I'm going to make four to be on the safe side. these, and I'm just gonna cut four with the middle of the three cutters. That one I'd like to do there. Have we got enough cutting film? Enough room? I'll just do it somewhere else. It's nice and glittery there, that was all. Right, that's four done, so I've got two spares. I need the smaller of these cutters, which is this one. So I shall do you over there, so I at least use them. One. Again, I'm going to do four because I always like to have spares on something like this, because you do not want to have to start all over again, do you? And they're only little, so it's not much waste. Right, so that's that. I also, now I might have to go over these just to catch those edges looking at that. I don't know if I pressed that one hard enough. And you. And you, you've been slightly dislodged when I did the other one. Right. I'm also going to, if I can see it, where is it? I'm also just going to try this nice new cutter doing one, and I want some copper in that one definitely, so say I'm going to do it there. There's a nice vein of blue running down that might show, and I didn't use the cling film, but never mind. Right, so I'm going to cut off the excess because that's not all getting used now. And I can remove this. Are you going to remove on your own? Okay, so then that's these done. Oh, I've got a little dog under my chair shaking with these fireworks. Night after night after night. And the firework moaner when it goes on and on and on. Burnishing them a little bit, get them sort of comfy before I pull the skeleton off. Right, let's get this off. Oh, this is going to be so much excess clay again. I need to stop moaning about excess clay. Trouble is, when it's this sort of colour, it's not so easy to reuse it and think of something. Because once this is mixed, it'll just go to that dark grey colour. So, okay, so I'm happy with them. And now I'm going to use the black to do the other pieces, which I'm also going to do on a number two. It's not enough, is it? This seems really dull after using the Cernit Pearl the last few weeks. I keep forgetting it's actually pearl. right, no. Needs another run. Gonna burnish it first. Find if you use your finger as well, it can help shut little holes, etc., and then you can go over and burnish it again. Right. Hopefully, that's nice smooth enough. Yeah. Right. Okay, so we want two of these. And I didn't use the cling film, but never mind. It's only on a two, and I can still, the edges look fine. And I'll put another one there, so I'm trying to see if they'll all fit. They probably won't, but I'll give it a go. Then I want the baby one, not that one, which will fit there. Another baby one there. I'm going to do two more just to be on the safe side of those little ones. And I need two of these big black ones, don't I? And that's it. So, one, two. Oh, I just went over, didn't I? I don't think that's going to fit. Never mind, I just have to roll it out again. It's not the end of the world. I'll just run this through again so I can get another one of those little ones just for a spare. And I'm going to get another one of those as well. Because there's nothing worse when it comes out the other side and you've got to do it all again. Because there's an air bubble or something or other that you didn't notice. See. That'll be okay, or does it need running through? That'll be fine there. That there. Right, that's more than enough of each. You've got a little spare in the way of a cross. Right, okay, so. Right, that all looks smooth. Awful feeling there's an air bubble in that one, looking at the shape of it, but time will tell. Can't see it at the moment. Just doesn't look quite right. Okay, so these are going to go into the oven at the manufacturer's recommended temperatures, and I will see you on the other side. Also, I'm going to do some cabochons. I don't know whether you'd need me to show you. A couple of people say about, let me show you this one. I haven't finished it yet because I've got to paint the top. But this one is where I did a cross stone, fantasy stone. So this one's going to be like an amulet hanging. Well, I've still got to paint all that up there silver. But it's a really nice shape. So I'm going to make one of those out of this. And just because I know a few people said they don't know how to use it, neither do I. I've just tried to work out a way that works. And that's how I use it. It works for me. It's probably a much easier way, but I don't know about it. So basically what I'll do is make sure I'm folding everything in so everything on the outside is stone. And give it a roll. And then I'll pull that off there. And then I'll try and make sure it moulds just like any other mould. You can still manipulate it really well. But I want to make a nice bottom on it. So I might actually choose something to go at the base. Like there. So that way at the bottom there's a bit of copper and light blue. So I'm rolling it. Now if I make it thicker than this, which sticks to the sides, it won't go right down. But I've still found a way to do it. So I tend to roll and slide. Get it to go down as far as you can. It's now decided it's stopping, but that's fine. I'll pull that off and I just get my, is it this one? I'm going to use this one. Big ball roller, and I just push and I'm manipulating it also with my fingers down to the bottom, because at the moment it hasn't gone down that far. I can see through it. So now I'm going to push up, and it doesn't matter because it's marbled and what have you, you should still end up with a nice shape. When I was trying these and I did one that was too dark, that it was too dark a blue, although I really love it, it still all looks really natural. I don't know if you can see that. So hopefully I'm manipulating that into place. It does take a minute and it is a little bit of a pain, but I think for what you get at the other side, it's really worth it. So keep mindful of what's going in and just keep pushing it in till you know it's full. And you will know, because you'll see, you can see, I can see now roughly whether that's gone to the bottom, which it has. That's more or less full now. My God. State of these hands. So I don't know if you can actually see the colour coming through, so it should be nicely marbled. I'm just doing this as an add-on because I know people have said they don't know how to use these, and I'm just showing you what I've managed to do. It works well. Hopefully, you've got to be careful that you don't leave any gaps, that's the only thing. I'm just going to give it a little roll and push it back in. And then this can go in the oven, so you haven't got to touch it till it comes out. But don't try to get it out until it's totally cold, that's one tip. So there's one cabochon I've done, the rest I'll do off camera. Okay, so these are going to go in the oven at the manufacturer's recommended temperature, and I'll see you on the other side. Okay. So I'm still in a mess, but they're out of the oven. Now, you've got the big ones of these are the middle, and then the little ones are the dark. What I've done with these, there's no point in putting resin on these because they're just going to bulk up. So I've just varnished those just to give them a shine and make them pop a little bit. I've just tidied the edges up on these. And then there's these ones here, which are to go on this one. So I'm going to do all four, see which two come up nicest. And the other thing I just wanted to show you quickly, this, I could be making a big mistake because there could be a big gap somewhere and I've messed up. There you go. What a lovely piece. And then of course you can either put a wire through or you can clay the top, whatever you want, just to make it into a sort of a pointed cabochon. I don't know what the name for them is. Okay, so I'm going to tidy that up as well. Alright, so I'll see you on the other side. Hi, all finished. That one's now resin to go with this one. And this one's varnish to go with this one, because resin would have just been too much. In fact, I think these three are a push. But I did do them on a number two. Have I got a number two here? And they're just so flimsy. I just didn't like it. It didn't feel strong. So, with these are these little ear hoops. Excuse my hands and nails again until I've finished all this, then I'll give them a, get rid of all the blooming ink and black clay. So, with these, they're quite popular, aren't they? But a lot of people don't know how to use them. So, with this one, to get the bits in, I just straighten that there. And then slip on what I need to. Now, because that's going to be doing up that way, I'll put it in underneath and backwards. That seems to make it easy to work out. So there's one. Then this one the same. And backwards in, underneath and backwards. Makes sense to me. And this one here is the hole. Underneath and backwards, and then I just want to literally finish them off with a tiny little let me get this round first, then I'll do it. Just want to get a tiny little copper seed bead. Whoa. On there. Okay, and then I'm just going to straighten that back up. Slip it in. And straight, there's the earrings. I've done the other one already to make it easier for you to, so you didn't have to watch the same thing twice, basically. Oops, get you straight. And then these ones, which are my favourite. It's literally a case of I've got a little pinch bail, which is big enough to hold both. And I should put that through the resin drum piece first. I'm trying really hard not to use fingers. Come on, in you go. And then I'm going to slip this one in behind and attach that to the other bail. The other bail nail, tack, whatever. And then I'm just going to, oh, I can see a fingerprint. Oh, I always do it. Didn't put the gloves on, did I? Okay, and then I've just got to open that up to add that in. Just in case anyone didn't know, they're either wire straighteners or you can use them, because it's rubber, you can use them to push findings in and that. So, you go like that, and I'll close that up. And then we've got another pair, which I really like those. Okay, and then I also made these. I made quite a bit more, but I've got these done. I also made these. I don't know how you're seeing these in the light, because this doesn't give true light or true colour. I'll come in a bit and try that first. Bring them over this way then. I don't know if you can see anything clearly. Because they're dark, it's hard to show you. I'll show you one by one anyway. So, just these blue, just plain ones. And I've just put a black finding on there. I think it looks quite nice. And obviously you've got these. And then these, which are my favourite, because there's something, I don't know, they look a bit classy. Alright, so that's those. Like I said, I have done other things. I've done some of these, which I've varnished that, so I'll get the shine, because I'm not going to try to resin it, it'd be a nightmare, and I will do something with it. I've also done these, which aren't resined yet. They're still waiting, but they will be different cabochons. They will come in handy. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed them, and I should hopefully be able to get a true colour picture when I take photos after. Okay, thanks, bye.